Hey everyone, it's Ramsey. If you're struggling to reach out to your yearly goals, you're in the right place. Now, every year, I've had a hard time reaching out the goals that I've set up in December. But beginning of this year, I've read a book called The 12-Week Year, and this really changed the way I tackle my goals. In this video, I'm gonna explain you what are the principles of this book, what's the idea behind The 12-Week Year, and what are the benefits of batching things into 12-week years. Then I'm gonna show you how it works, and how I've set it up in my favorite project management tool, ClickUp. I will share with you a ClickUp template that lets you batch your year in 12 weeks and achieve more goals. Now, let's start off by understanding the principles behind the 12-week year. This book was written by Brian P. Moran and Michael Lennington, and the idea behind this book is that your thinking, the way you batch your years, determines your action and your result. Say my year is 52 weeks, that leaves you 52 weeks to achieve a yearly goal. But the thing is that the brain has a hard time comprehending what 52 weeks are. Whereas if you transform your year into batches of 12 weeks, everything becomes more sizable and reachable because you're gonna start to say, my year is a 12-week period. And if I set a goal that I have to achieve within this 12-week period, it will become realistic, because this will not seem far-stretched. 12 weeks is a pretty short time. You can easily comprehend when these 12 weeks will be. If you set your yearly goal in December, you will lose track of it starting March, April. It will not start to make sense anymore. Companies have been doing this for a while now with quarterly goals, and this is basically the same idea. Starting the 1st of January, you will say my year finishes end of March, and end of March, I have to have reached my 12-week year goal. And that's the idea behind it. Now I've laid out what the benefits of this method is, the whys behind it, and why the authors want you to work in 12-week years. The first reason is that it brings you more predictability, because a 12-week year makes plans easier to follow. There's less seasonality, there's less uncertainty. If you start setting something for a year and something comes up in the middle of that year, your plans change, it might undermine your yearly goal. Now the second reason is that it brings you more focus. Having a 12-year period motivates you to take immediate action. It motivates you to get things done as soon as possible. It adds intensity, it adds energy, it will make you achieve more. And the last reason is that it will bring you more structure. A 12-month plan is a bit hard to assess, hard to fathom, whereas a 12-week plan is clearer, you'll have clear goals, and you'll be able to align these goals with your weekly goals as well as your daily actions. Now I'm going to show you how to break down your 12 weeks here. Your 12 weeks here needs to be part of something bigger. It's part of a vision that you have. If you've seen my video on the getting things done method, and if you haven't, you can find the link in the description, you'll be to understand that any framework, any system has to be embedded into your vision. Your vision is fundamental to your action. Your vision will drive your goals, which will drive your 12-week plan, which will drive your weekly goals, and then finally your daily tasks. I will say my vision is, say, to reach 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year on YouTube. Then my goals will be aligned with that vision of the 10,000 subscribers. It might be something like recording 4 videos per week. Now my 12-week plan could be something like recording 24 videos. And then my weekly goals could be something like recording 2 videos this week. And then my daily task will break down how to record these 2 videos. It could be day 1, do some research, day 2, write the 2 scripts, day 3, record myself, day 4, edit, day 5, publish, something like that. This 12-week year has been achieved because it started from a higher vision and then was broken down into smaller steps that are sizable and achievable. Next, I'm going to show you how this method works. What are the steps behind it? And I've already summarized it by splitting it down the vision into actions, but here you'll be able to understand more in details how it works. The first thing you have to do is set your goals for a 12-week time frame. Then you have to break down these goals into weekly actions, something that's more tangible and that you have to reach by Sunday. And then focus on execution. You have to execute, you have to feel accountable. You should minimize the failures to your weekly goals as much as possible. You need to understand why you failed. Was it a matter of accountability? Was it a matter of having too big of a goal? Was it a matter of motivation? You have to assess this because achieving your weekly goals in this 12-week year framework is fundamental to its success. Now you have to measure your progress. At the end of your 12-week year, there is a review that you have to do to understand, have you achieved your goal? Why? Why not? What can you do to improve on the next 12-week year? Next point, you have to adapt yourself. You're like an athlete. If over the last week you've achieved more than you planned, you can set a more ambitious weekly goal for the next one. Or on the other hand, if you're not as good as you expected, you can bring your expectations a little bit down. You have to adjust this. You have to play with your capacities, play with your productivity, and you have to make sure that your weekly goals and your 12-week year is a great balance between being achievable and being ambitious. And then the last point, and a big, big idea of that book, is that you have to maintain a sense of urgency, a sense of intensity, of joy into everything that you do. You have to make sure that you are in tune with that cycle, in tune with that 12-week flow. Now that you've understood the principles and how this method works, I'm going to show you how I've set it up into my favorite software, ClickUp. Stay till the end, because if you get to understand that system into ClickUp and how my template looks like, you'll be able to achieve much more in that year. What I did is that I went into ClickUp and I've asked myself, what's the best way to represent this framework into the software? So I created a folder containing my 12-week year template. And inside there, there's three lists for my goals, for my 12-week year, and for my to-do list. So you have your 12-week years, which are your goals that you need to reach out, and they are going to be all listed into one single list. And then everything gets split up into your weekly goals. And from there, everything gets split up to a third level, to sub task, into your actionable tasks that you can then potentially add to your getting things done framework. Kind of mixed the 12-week year framework with the getting things done framework, so that I could get the best of both worlds. I have my big vision, I have my 12-week year, the plan that I need to achieve by the end of the upcoming 12 weeks, fall into my to-do list, because sometimes I might have things that are not within that plan, but that I have to do. For example, some personal actions or something that come up in the middle of the week. So everything then moves from my 12-week year to-do to my getting things done inbox. But you don't have to do that. We're only going to focus on the 12-week year, and I'm going to show you how you can create actionable tasks that fall into your vision. Now we're going to move straight to ClickUp, and I'm going to show you how it looks. When you're in ClickUp, you're going to land on this document, which will help you build your 12-week year. This is a document to really take a step back and build your vision as well as your upcoming goals. You have to take your time to fill this in. In this document, you'll have to fill in your values, fill in what your ideal life looks like, and what will help you get closer to your vision. And it's basically the principles of the 12-week year. You're going to be able to build the next 12-week year periods. So you'll have to fill in the prompts, and this will help you out clarify your target and have something actionable to finish by the end of the week. And what that means is that once every 12 weeks, you have to fill in what's inside the goals here. And once a week, you have to fill in your 12-week year task. And I'll show you how that looks later. Now, if we go down a bit more, you will have to break down your weekly goals into tasks, because it's hard to achieve something weekly when you don't have actions to do day to day. It's important to split everything up into tasks. You can go from 1 to 20 tasks. It really doesn't matter, as long as you know that you can achieve them and that they're sizable. You have to break down this weekly goal into tasks, and that goes into your to-do list that's right here. Now, let's start off with the goals. When you land on the template, you'll have to name your 12-week year goal. It has to be something ambitious, something that inspires you, something that will make you feel joy if you achieve it at the end of the 12 weeks. What you have to understand is that if you download this template, you can create as many folders as you want for each life areas. There could be a 12-week year for your business life, but also a 12-week year for your relationships or a 12-week year for your health. You have to split up everything the way you want. I would advise you to go between 1 and 3 life areas. What I personally do is that I have a 12-week year for business life and a 12-week year for personal life. We're going to assume that we're using the 12-week year template for our personal life. Here I'm going to add a 12-week goal that I want to achieve for my personal life, and that's going to be improve personal fitness and health. Now, what you can see here is that this task is recurring. which means ClickUp will create a new task on each 12-week year, and you don't have to bother with creating the task yourself and reapplying the template. Now, if I open up the task Improve Personal Fitness and Health, it will ask me to describe in detail the goal that I want to achieve and to make sure that it's specific, measurable, achievable, yet ambitious. All right, so what I'm going to do is fill it in. I filled that in and I said that by the end of the 12-week period, I will have more stamina, feel stronger, and sleep better. And I've put some specific goals, like reducing my body fat by 3%, running 5 kilometers continuously, and having a consistent daily habit of hydration and sufficient sleep. I could even say like 8 hours a night, for example. And then I want to feel more confident, healthier, and increase my mood. So I've really described in detail what I want to achieve, and I've made this goal more conscious and more intentional. And that's one big idea behind the 12-week year. Now, I want to do this within 12 weeks. I have to set up realistic weekly goals. Otherwise, I'll never achieve it. If I just say, I want to do this, I want to feel better, and I want to feel healthier. If I don't have weekly targets, I will never attain these goals, like reducing my body fat by 3% or running my 5 kilometers or having a daily habit of sleep. Now, let's start by our first week. I'm going to leave this task here and I'm going to go into my 12-week year. Now, I'm in my current 12-week year, and I will start laying out my first week's goals. And I'd advise you to lay out the whole 12 weeks, and this could potentially change. You don't have to stick to it. You can be flexible and you can change your goals for week 10, 11, 12, if that changes over time, as long as it's aligned with your 12-week year. Now, I'm gonna fill up a few weeks to show you how it looks. I'm gonna increase the duration of workouts from 30 minutes to 45 minutes. Then I'm gonna add 1 day of yoga per week for flexibility. And then it could be something like reduce fast food intake to once a week. And then maybe once I've instilled these 3 habits, I could actually say, stick to my good habits over the next 12 weeks. So what you have to understand is that if your 12-week year is habit-based, like this one, once you've set up the healthy habits over the upcoming weeks, you can actually have a goal, which is executing, achieving these habits in my routine. I could say something like, make sure I follow my good habits. We can actually copy this and paste it in the upcoming weeks. And then to track if you've achieved your 12-week year, you can go here and say done, failed, in progress, or to do. And now the next step is to break down each of the weeks. Now for this one, you only need to break down the upcoming week. You don't have to break down all the weeks. So every Sunday or every Monday morning, you have to get in front of your laptop, get into that first week, and break it down. So I'll add a subtask, and this could be something like having 4 sessions in the upcoming week, a morning jog for 45 minutes, a gym session for 45 minutes, and a swim for 45 minutes, and another morning jog, say on Friday. Now I have my weekly goal and I have my daily actions. You don't have to have 7 actions, 1 action each day. It really depends on what you want to achieve and what your goals are. You have to stay flexible. Maybe if it's a fitness goal like this one, you can have fitness sessions only 4 times a week, and that'll make you achieve your 12-week year. Now you can open up one of these weekly goals if you want to. Now, if your weekly goal is specific enough, you don't have to fill this, but this can help you out, make it clearer if it's not. What's great with the split between goals, 12-week year, and to-do is that you can now go into your to-do list and have what you have to do for the week appearing in one single list. And this is the power of a ClickUp template like this and of automations, because it really breaks down everything into smaller, sizable actions that will actually help you get things done. So once you've done your morning jog, you can say you've done it. If you failed it, you can also say you failed it. This will help you track what you've done, what you failed. And now say I've done my gym session, but I have failed on swimming and I've done everything else. Okay, perfect. I have 3 tasks done and 1 that's not. And if we go into our 12 weeks here, we'll be able to see that we've only achieved 75%. So we can consider that the week is failed, and you have to be harsh with yourself on this one. Because if you haven't achieved 100%, it means your weekly goal was either too ambitious or you didn't commit to it. And by accumulating all of these failed vision and all of these achieved visions, say you've achieved this one, you'll be able to break down if you were successful, if you were ambitious enough, and if you were able to commit to what you promised yourself. This really helps you be conscious about what you've done and what you haven't, because we tend to forget way too much the goals we set up for ourselves and what we failed on, and we don't celebrate enough what you've succeeded on. Make sure you remember what you failed and make sure you celebrate what you achieved. This system works the same way for your weekly goal than for your 12-week year. If you go to your goal list, you'll be able to know if you've achieved your 12-week year and to what percentage. And you can decide of a threshold that will make you consider that you've done or failed your 12-week year. Say you're below 80%, it means you failed your 12 weeks here. And say you're above 80%, it means you have done your 12 weeks here. Now, by accumulating your weekly goals and your daily actions, you'll be able to get a broader picture of what you've done, and you'll be able to achieve ambitious goals like improving your personal fitness and health, not in a year, but in 12 weeks. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to grab this template, there's a link in the description. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments. And I'll see you next time for another productivity and systems video. Take care of yourself and stay productive.